So I am Kimihiko Kaneko from Tohoku University in Japan. And in my poster presentation, I report my retrospective study on the efficacy of interferon beta for demyelinating disorder with MOG antibody. And recent study is showing that MOG IgG detected in CBA is detected in mainly acquaporin 4 antibody negative neuromyelinated spectrum, optical spectrum disorder or pediatric ADEM, but it's not detected in typical MS. But in clinical practice, MOG antibody positive cases may be diagnosed as MS because they have clinically relapsing course and they have multiple CNS lesion, which is similar to dissemination in space. But importantly, MOG antibody positive case, in CSF, MOG antibody positive cases, upregulation TF17 relating cytokine is observed, and this is similar to acquaporin 4 antibody positive NMOS spectrum disorder and quite different from multiple sclerosis. And one more important thing is interferon beta is reported to deteriorate the disease activity of acquaporin 4 antibody positive neuromyelitis spectrum disorder, which led us to think that similar effect seen in acquaporin 4 antibody positive neuromyelitis spectrum disorder is also seen in MOG antibody positive cases. And as a result, we found 20 and 8 patients who is MOG IgG positive and also have a previous history of interferon beta treatment. And beneficial effect seeing MS is not observed in MOG positive cases. And actually, there are many frequent and early relapse in MOG positive cases after the initiation of interferon beta treatment. And annual relapsing rate is even or much higher in the period when interferon beta is used compared with the period interferon beta is not used. So from my research, my conclusion is interferon beta is not recommended to use for anti-MOG positive demyelinating disorder. And this is one of the important findings to consider the pathology of MOG antibody positive cases. And in the future, to diagnose MS, MOG antibody testing should be included in the criteria. Thank you very much.